Tiger Woods, right now. I don't know if that's accurate at this moment. I did look it up. I'll look it up again, but I believe he's 150-1 to win the Masters. And this is the highest odds Tiger has ever been. Now, you do bet a little bit of golf. I do dabble in it a little bit. He's won the Masters 5 times. His last major win was in 2019, which I thought was not like that long ago.
It wasn't. That was a huge win.
And it was at Augusta. It wasn't the Masters tournament. You know, his numbers speak for themselves. Player of the Year 11 times. PGA Tour Player of the Year 11 times. Money Leader 10 times. Brian Nelson Award. Vardon Trophy 9 times. Like, you know, obviously a GOAT in the sport. And still behind Jack, right? Probably won't catch Jack. It looked like he would have. He has 15 majors. Jack has 18. Now, we kind of, when I sent this note to you already, you already kind of hit me back like, yo, man. I mean, his body's giving up on him. It was kind of what it looks like. But looking at this now, 151, is that like insane? Like, are they trying to induce people to bet Tiger just because people know who Tiger Woods is? But I feel like the casual golf bettor is smarter than betting Tiger Woods at this moment and at this point. I feel like people already know, you know what I mean, Tiger Woods is, you know what I mean, kind of washed at this point. So what do you think about these odds? What do you think about his chances to at least make the cut at the Masters at this point? And would you bet him not to make the cut at the Masters at this point?
Okay, I'll give it to you like this. I think it's brilliant. I think he's scaled right where he should be. Tiger Woods is arguably one of the best to ever do it. Probably one of the best athletes to ever do it. I want to give him all the flowers he deserves. We're in 2024, unfortunately, and his body is now shown that he just cannot stand 4 days of intense golf. It's just tough. I don't think he's made the cut in the last 4 majors. That's not even just making it to Saturday. And it shows. So I don't think anything's changed with that. I don't think anything's going to change with that this year. I think the 150-1 is enticing because it's Tiger Woods. And it's like, oh, maybe just put a little, let me sprinkle a little bit on it just in case. So the book is going to make some money off that just off a name regardless. And then they'll get a little bit more off because they're like, well, hold on. Tiger, if anybody can do it, Tiger can do it. So, yeah. I mean, even me thinking that possibly you could sprinkle something on that at 150-1 sounds like a good plan. But unfortunately, my bet is on the opposite side. I got the money on Tiger was not making a cut. And that was priced at one, I think at the time, minus 115. I think it got up to possibly now like minus 130 for him not to make the cut. So the odds is not in favor to make it to Saturday. Definitely not making it to Sunday, which we all would like to see. But yeah, it's a lot of good young golfers out here making their way, making a stamp on in the league between PGA and the LIV tournament. So it's going to be tough for Tiger Woods to kind of withstand the Masters grind with his body the way it is.
And the way that this is DraftKings has it, there's a Tiger special just for Tiger Woods, and they're just trying to induce people right now. Top 40 is him. He's at minus 120. And Tiger, the Masters, these are the bets right now on Tiger Woods that you can do. They're doing specifically for Tiger. Tiger Woods, any bogey, free round, plus 1,200. Yes. Tiger Woods, a hole-in-one on hole 4, plus 40,000. Tiger Woods holding one on 6, 12, 16. You know, those are high odds. So Tiger Woods to break the course record. And Tiger Woods to make it to Albatross 2000. So be careful, everybody, who is thinking about betting Tiger Woods and you're just trying to bet to bet. He's a name. He's a trigger name. And people in the industry know that. So that's why he has his own specials.